Hello to all of the faculty, parents, and especially 2020 graduates. My name is Luke Prairie, and you may know me as the kid who studied for the SAT a lot, and I am proud to be standing before you as your class valedictorian. Before I begin, I would also like to remind all of you that you all have the opportunity to turn me off whenever you feel like it, which is a luxury not even my parents have. So, first off, congratulations to all of the graduates. I would ask all of you to give yourselves a round of applause, but I'm currently talking to hundreds of empty seats. And on that note, we obviously lost quite a lot over the past few months, first of which, prom. You know, it's kind of sad we're not going to be able to see each other dance to the Macarena or listen to other G-rated music from three decades ago. But, as the great philosopher Snoop Dogg once said, sometimes a loss is the best thing that can happen. It teaches you what you should have done next time. So instead of treading on the what-ifs and what could have been, I'd like to relive some of our memories of when we entered through the majestic gates of Moments High School four short years ago. Starting off with freshman year, I think we did pretty well, and that's saying a lot considering how high the bar was set by the previous generation of bright, disciplined freshmen we had the difficult task of replacing. Next, sophomore year, the year we all got our Chromebooks. Each day, we reached to the bounds of the internet, accessing more information in a single click than previous generations could have with hours at the library. And what did we do with this power? Beg for Kahoot every day during class, obviously. And then junior year. This is when the pressure really started to build for most of us. Most of us had our first SAT. That was like my fifth SAT. And this was also the beginning of a two-year period in which any family member you've ever known would ask you what you were going to do with your life, as apparently being a professional Fortnite player was not realistic. And now we are at the end of our senior year. We survived the crazy homecoming shenanigans. We became close as a class under the Friday night lights of the football field. We donated coats and provided Thanksgiving meals to needy families. And now it's time for all of that to come to an end. And our year got cut too short. We aren't able to say our proper goodbyes to our teachers, our custodians, our receptionists, and other staff. So on behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank each and every one of you for supporting us during the past 4 years. I even say that to Mr. Sala, who made fun of my outfits on a daily basis, Mr. Perch, who mocked my pronunciations in the morning announcements, and Mr. Rounds, who gave me the thoughtful nickname Bedhead. But for the rest of us graduates, we won't be able to say goodbye to each other. And that really stings, as for some of us have been together far before high school, since preschool even. And as we all move on to the next chapter in our life, you're not going to remember your grades or how stressed you were during finals. You're going to remember the relationships you made here. So remember all of your friends, the good memories and even the bad ones, and use those to define how you want to be as a person. And finally, let's not forget the most important people of all, our parents, or guardians, or as Miss Ada would call them, the true OGs. I mean, they did do some pretty cool stuff. They birthed us, they fed us, and you can't really compete with that. So, even though it might be a struggle, I urge all of you to let your guard down and thank them. And then we can go back to being snarky teenagers. So as I wrap this speech up, I want to acknowledge the many of you that are going off to community college, trade school, university, military, or those who still need time. In any case, I'd like to share a quote from Jimmy Iovine, who says, "That diploma you hold in your hands today is really just your learner's permit for the rest of the drive through life. Remember, you don't have to be smarter than the next person. All you have to do is be willing to work harder than the next person." So in conclusion, I just want to say how proud I am of each and every one of you. And I'm super thrilled to see how all of our futures pan out. Thank you, and have a great day.